Today, I'm working on the snapper again. I have a crank and no start snapper that I worked on last week, where when you turn the key, nothing happened. I diagnosed that problem and fixed it. If you want to see that video, it's in the link up above. After I cut the grass, a little over a week went by. I go to start it the other day, cranking over, but no start. I put a little fuel into the carburetor and she started up and died down once that fuel was gone. So now I know I have a fuel issue. But I did notice when I'm cranking this engine, the gas seems to be bubbling up in this filter. Let me show you that. Now it's even worse. Gas isn't being pulled up. There we go. Gas is starting to come to the top now. Put a little fuel into the carburetor again just to help it go. Don't want to burn out the starter. It's not happening now. You can see gas isn't being sucked through this fuel filter. Yesterday when I was working on it, this fuel filter was full of gas, but it was bubbling over in it. So I was thinking maybe it was the anti-kickback solenoid not opening up. But when you turn the key, you can hear it click. Okay, so we know that's working over there. Next, I'm gonna pull this off. This fuel pump works off a vacuum. I'm going to take this fuel pump off, then I'm going to check over here to see if I have a vacuum coming out and how strong that vacuum is. Normally I would take this hose off to see if any fuel's being pumped out, but we know it's not being pumped out because it's not going through. So what I'm going to do now is disconnect this fuel line to see if there's any obstruction in the line, if the fuel flows out. This gas tank is behind the seat. I might have to pick up the back end to see if that works. That's a no-go. If you look at the arrow, the fuel line is connected to the top of the tank, not the bottom. So tilting it won't do any good. What I did while I was waiting for the compressor to fill with air, I got this spare gas tank, connected it to the pump, put some gas in it, tried starting it up. Wouldn't start. Put some gas into the carburetor, it ran while that gas was available. As soon as that ran out, it stopped. My next step, I'm going to remove this gas line that goes to the carburetor, connect the gas tank to it, and see if it starts. If it starts then I know I have a gas pump problem. If it doesn't start, then I know I have a problem with the carburetor. But I still think it's this pump, because it's not running gas through. Let's see. Okay, it didn't work with the gravity feed. I'm going to be pulling this carburetor off to see what's going on. And while this was disconnected, it was spitting out some of the gas that was in there. So some gas did get in there from this tank. You know what? I'm going to connect the tank back to this and see what kind of flow we get out of here. Okay, what I have is the gas tank connected to the pump, a hose going into this tank. We'll see how this pump works with a fresh gas supply. No obstruction. Well, it wasn't pumping all that great, and the reason the engine was running is because I had this fuel line with this fuel filter poking into the carburetor, and it was running off the fuel that was in that fuel filter. Now, this gas is pretty bad. There's all kinds of debris in there. Maybe that's what's messing up this fuel pump too. I'm gonna have to drain this tank, and I'm not quite sure. I have one of those pumps to take the oil out of a crankcase. It has a long, thin nozzle. I think what I'm gonna do is put that up in here and see if I can suck the gas out that way and get this debris out of there. Ran fine last week, but with that kind of mess in there, this is what was in the fuel pump. Because this tank I know is clean. This I actually washed out last year, and I had it on the shelf as a backup tank. I'm gonna run that pump a little bit more, see if I could blow out any more of this stuff that's in here, and see what happens from that point. Reconnect it to the gas line and see if I could get it to run off this tank. Once I figure out what's going on here, I'll be back. I believe I found the problem. This is a fuel pump off a tractor that's about 30 years old. It has the same serial number as this one that I pulled off, and it does pump. I did pump it off camera. I'm gonna run it one more time to show you that it's pumping out, and just to make sure that it keeps coming out for myself. Then I'll hook it up to the carburetor. Okay, let's see what we have here. I have the gas tank cleaned out. There's the fuel line on top, like I mentioned earlier. Goes straight down to the bottom. There's a hose in there. This is the safety switch for the seat. The line has no obstructions in it. Fuel line is good. New fuel filter going to the new fuel pump. And I have the hose connected to that gallon. We'll see how this flows. Let me position this camera and we'll get started. There we go. That's it. It was the fuel pump all along. Well, this carburetor also has to be cleaned out. I did connect it to the carburetor. When I had it connected, the engine was hunting. But for now, this is done. It's a repair. If you found this video useful or entertaining, and you would like to help me grow this channel so I could keep making videos like this, share it with someone else who might be able to use it. Give it a like. Post your comments down below. And if you haven't done so already, subscribe. It means a lot, and I do appreciate it. Until next time, stay safe.